Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and this is a guitar that I've been waiting for all of 2021. This is the brand new limited edition Epiphone Jarrah James Nichols signature Les Paul Custom Gold Glory. If you're unfamiliar with Mr. Jarrah James Nichols and only came here because there's a beautiful gorgeous gold top on your screens, Jarrah jumped onto the scene a few years ago and immediately took the admiration and respect of some of the most legendary blues artists of all time. The dude is an absolute monster when it comes to playing the guitar, and he doesn't use a pick, he uses his fingers. So sorry, any Jarrah aficionados, if you're watching this, I'm not going to use my fingers because I'm not as good as Jarrah. I was one of the first people to ever interview Jarrah when he came to the UK, I believe, many, many years ago, and stayed in touch over the years. And I've got to tell you, he's as humble and awesome now. Now he's extremely well known as he was back in the day. And now he's got two signature guitars from Epiphone under his hat. The first one being Old Glory, which is this guy. This is my own personal Old Glory. There's a video on the channel of me demoing this. I'll put a link in the description box down below. This is original Old Glory, based off his actual Gibson Old Glory, which is a custom shop Les Paul, based off 55 specs, kind of a cool cross-pollination of Les Paul Junior and Les Paul Custom. Everybody loved this, including myself. But with that, who doesn't enjoy being flashy, and who doesn't love a good gold top? So when you combine Old Glory with gold top, you get Gold Glory. And spec-wise, it's pretty much the same as Old Glory. If you've never played one of these guitars, it's such a unique feeling and sounding guitar. It's got all the girth and the weight of a Les Paul Custom, but with that mid-focus gnarl, because there's only one P90 in it. Now, if you're unfamiliar with the specs of Gold Glory or Old Glory, it's that classic Les Paul recipe. Mahogany construction, a beautiful mahogany body with a set mahogany neck. Now, the body itself is weighty, just like a Les Paul Custom should be, but it's not too heavy. You haven't got to be the size of Jarrah to throw this around on stage. And the neck is just glorious. It's a proper 50s rounded C profile. It's a chunky lad, but it feels amazing. There's thousands of folk online chatting in forums saying the tone is in the neck. And if that's the case, this has a lot of tone. The fingerboard is glorious as well. It's an ebony fingerboard with 22 medium jumbo frets, and it's a 12-inch radius, so it's kind of curved. It's just very, very beautiful Les Paul. And you'll notice as well, the block inlays don't go anywhere past the 15th fret. That was the same on Old Glory, and I asked Jarrah this, and that's because he wants a more sleeker line for the Les Paul. Doesn't want anything getting in the way with the inlays past the 15th. The day this guitar was released, I had the pleasure of chatting to Mr. Jarrah James Nichols live through Zoom and the internet. He was live from the Gibson garage in Nashville, the amazing new Gibson headquarters in Nashville, and we chatted everything Old Glory, everything Gold Glory, and why this guitar came about. So again, I'll link that in the description box down below to hear us chatting about the guitar and some amazing playing from the man himself. One cool thing as well to note is the new, inspired by Gibson, it's the new old school Kalamazoo Epiphone headstock, more akin to a Gibson, so it's got the open book up top and a slightly larger diamond compared to the old one. I dig them both, but this is probably more modern Gibson kind of chat with them both as well. They are in essence the same guitar. However, I'm debating buying this one, even though I already have that one. It's the kind of thing where they do the same thing, but they're just such, like, they're almost like salt and pepper. You've got to have them together. You've got to have the Jarrah James Nichols set. On the back of the headstock, you'll find the stinger. On Old Glory, it was contrasting white, but on Gold Glory, it's contrasting black. Tuning peg wise, it features Grover tuners. And that leads me on to a really unique feature, and the fact that these are almost aged nickel tuners. and the bridge is aged as well. Not massively aged, it's just kind of like brushed nickel, and you rarely see that on Epiphone guitars, so the nickel has been kind of beautifully aged to match the awesome aesthetic of this guitar. So, moving back down the body, it's a bound neck and a bound headstock, and the whole body is bound. 7-ply binding on the front and 5-ply on the back. With the bridge, you get a single wraparound tailpiece with the lightning bolt to help with intonation on the guitar, because there's no little tune-o-matic bridge like you find on regular Gibsons. And two little grub screws down the back as well to also help with intonation. The single pickup on this guitar is a proper Seymour Duncan P90, exactly the same as what Mr. James Nichols uses in his guitars. One volume, one tone, and these are CTS pots, so the best of the best pots. Jared relies on the volume and the tone of the guitar to get as many different voicings as he can from a single pickup guitar, so they get hammered quite a bit, so they've got to be good quality, and these are. Now let's talk about the colour. It looks amazing on camera. It's amazing in person, it's amazing on camera. This is Gold Glory, it's a gold top, but it's double gold. It's twice the amount of gold you get on a gold top. So this is essentially painted twice to give it a much deeper, richer gold. When you see this next to a gold top, this has a lot more depth to it. It's not like sparkling metallic gold. That's not like how it's coming across. It's just kind of, it's a rich gold, it's a deep gold, and it's all the way around. Mostly, most of the time, gold tops have a dark back, either a natural back or a painted dark back. This is gold all the way around and all the way up the neck. And the fact that it's satin as well is so smooth under your hand on that neck. With the double gold as well, you can really see the carving of that top. It's a beautiful arch. Bravo Epiphone and bravo Jared, this is one hell of a guitar. And when you buy it, it comes with a Epilite Epiphone hard soft case. If you want to check that out, watch my unboxing of this guitar when my mind's blown in one of the last PMT vlogs. Again, I'll put that in the link down in the description box down below. And I think that's all the specs. Blackstar HD Stage 100 Watt Mark II Head and Cab, Two Notes Torpedo Captor X, me, Gold Glory. Thing just resonates like nothing else. When there's only one pickup on your guitar, you get the truest vibration of the strings. And I always harp on about this in junior videos and like Kramer Beretta videos, but when there's no other pickups, there's no other magnets pulling on the strings, so you get the purest sound going into that proper Seymour Duncan P90. Great tone pot as well, because if you want neck pickup tones, as you've heard, just roll the tone control down. It's just proper Eric Clapton, kind of American woman-y. Such beautiful mid-range from a set neck mahogany guitar with a P90 in. And there's more to it than a Les Paul Jr. because Les Paul Juniors are very thin. This is a chunky lad, like I keep saying. it's very hard to knock out a tune as well. Because it's so simple, it's just, there's not a lot of movement. It's got a Graphtec Newbone nut as well, which is super smooth. Yeah, it's a great guitar. Beautiful clean tones. Ladies and gents, I believe that's all the specs, sights, and sounds I can give you on the old Gold Glory by Epiphone, the Jared James Nichols signature guitar. It's an absolutely phenomenal thing, and I do think I need to buy one to make it the complete set. Both amazing guitars with their own unique designs, and like I say, this is limited edition, so this double gold Les Paul Junior Les Paul Custom isn't going to be around forever. Whether you're a Jared fan or not, this is just a great guitar to play, feel, and hear. It's badass. Let me know down below in the comments what you think of this absolute beast. And if you enjoyed this video, give it a like and subscribe to PMTVUK on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music-related content. If you want any more information on the Epiphone Gold Glory or Old Glory or any Epiphone for that matter, get your fine self to PMTonline.co.uk or call into one of our forever expanding lovely PMT stores. We are PMT House of Rock on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of this with nice filters on. I've been Dagan, and I'll see you next time.